How to construct a filtration chamber for biodigesters is what this video is about. I'm going to show you how you are not going to get into trouble when you put your toilet wastewater into a drainage system gutter, which is nearest or closest to your property in this particular video.
This is the outlet. So what we are going to do is to do filtration here. We have terminated the pipe, the outlet pipe. And we are going to do some dog work inside.
In this particular situation, we do have the waistline, which is the leachate pipe, going all the way into the gutter. So what we are going to do is to do a filtration chamber just to filter the water and give it a better option in terms of the cleaning, and then remove any scent or smell that might possibly go into the gutter. You dig it rectangular shape just to match the pipe. We are laying the block, creating that chamber nicely in the chamber. We are doing some mortar work, but we want it to last for a long time. That's why we are doing like that. Make sure that the chamber has got a gradient in it. It's got a slope that is going to let the water out of the first part, and then the filtration will happen in that chamber there before it continues to the gutter. In some cases, you can do two or three chambers or filtration chambers depending on how clean you want the water to be. If it's only going into the drainage system and there's a running water and it's taking it away, you will not have a problem just doing one chamber. But if it's a stagnant water, sometimes you'll be forced to do two or three chambers. But we are showing you how to. This same chamber can be done for the leachate pipe leading to the soakaway as well, because probably you want to use the soakaway wastewater for any other purpose, like watering the garden or watering the plants in your backyard, or using the water just for gardening purposes. Such a chamber can also be done in that situation. So the mortar work being done is key, with the level that you need, especially for the gradient that will be going to join the other pipe going all the way into the drainage system. In Ghana, 5 cedis charcoal, bag of charcoal, just to lay them into the chamber. The idea is that you do not want the water that is going out to smell, and charcoal does that job perfectly. The chippings come on top because then you don't want the charcoal to rise and block the pipes or block the water from passing through the pipe. So you want it to be such a way that the chippings will come on top of the charcoal, and then there will be a way for the water just to go to where it's supposed to go. Make sure you do not block the leachate pipe with unnecessary stuffs. But the key part is you want the water to seep slowly out of the chamber into the gutter or into the soakaway or wherever it is going. It is key to just do it like this to remove any scent and then get a cleaner wastewater. Remember, there's filtration porous in the digester, which is cleaning, and then there's filtration material in the digester, which is doing the cleaning. We are also doing filtration here. So it's just called enhanced filtration, enhancing the wastewater treatment that you're having done. So you put the, in our case, we're just modifying the whole system because ideally you need to get a slab. Then by the time you go to the site and on the go, you are doing this construction and you're realizing the situation. You can use block just to do it and fold the sides and use mortar just to hold it firmly. And then you can get back with a topsoil on it. Or if you have a black rubber, you can equally put a black rubber on it just to make sure that no sand passes through the holes that will be left. And then you can have it filled up. The next video that's showing up is going to show you how to construct a biodigester and construct a wall for your dream house.